Hi everyone. In this video, I will discuss the concept of the equilibrium constant lab. Your goal in this lab is two things. First, you want to determine the value of the equilibrium constant, Kc, for a specific target reaction. And then what you're going to do is you're going to test, using the concept of the equilibrium constant, whether it's possible for the target reaction to have an alternative stoichiometry. What is the target reaction that you're going to be working with? The reaction is written here, which is iron complex with water, iron 3 plus thiocyanate going to iron thiocyanate and water. Now, usually because water doesn't change the charges on the species, the reaction is just written in a simpler form like this, but the correct form is really the top one right here. This type of reaction is what we refer to as a complex ion formation reaction. So the question is, what is a complex ion? Now, if you've taken Chem 11 before, we discussed complex ion in one of the labs that we did, which is the iron phenanthrolene complex ion. However, it's possible that you didn't do that lab or you didn't take Chem 11 at Santa Monica. So I'm going to give you a brief overview of complex ion, and in a couple of chapters from now, we would actually spend time discussing equilibrium consisting of complex ion formation. So what is a complex ion? It's basically an ionic species that's formed by covalent bonding between specifically two types of species. One would be a transition metal cation. So a transition metal, remember, it's in the middle part of the periodic table on the metal side. And so you can have your transition metal as iron, copper, manganese, nickel, cobalt. All of those could serve as a transition metal cation. And the second species that makes a bond with the transition metal is called a ligand. And that is a species with one or more lone pairs in its structure. So you remember drawing Lewis structures in Chem 11. And some molecules have lone pairs around them, for example, water. You can draw water looking like this, and you have lone pairs, this one and that one, and those could be used to bond with the transition metal. So water is an example, SCN- is the one that we'll use in this particular lab. All of these species with the free lone pairs are called ligands. So usually the complex ion is formed by one metal bonding with several ligands. Now, one unique property of a complex ion is that it has a lot of colors. It's usually very colorful, bright colors. Here's an example of a picture of copper 2+ complex ions with various types of ligands. So you have different types of ligands here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you can see that the copper complex ions basically have colors ranging from blue to green to a combination of blue and green and so on. In our particular experiment, our FeSCN2+, which is our complex ion, iron thiocyanate, is going to have a red-orange color. So as I said earlier, our goal is to calculate equilibrium constant. So to do that, we have to first write the equilibrium constant expression. So our target reaction looks like this. And our equilibrium constant, therefore, would be concentration of product, which is FeSCN2+. Divided by concentration of reactants, Fe3+ times SCN-. And remember that these are all concentration at equilibrium. Okay, so they're not initial concentration. Now, as you'll see in lecture, or you have seen in lecture, the way we would calculate these values of concentration of equilibrium is to use a method called the ICE table, which stands for initial, change, and equilibrium. So what you do is you write your reaction on the top, and then on the left side, you have a column, three different rows that's titled ICE for initial concentration, change in the concentration, and equilibrium concentration. So the way you're going to do this is that you're going to have some starting concentration of reactants, which here is denoted by Fe3-naught, which just means that's the initial concentration of iron that you put into your test tube, and then you have your initial concentration of thiocyanate, which also you put into your test tube. Both of these you can calculate. That's part of the lab procedure. And then, of course, at the beginning, you have no product, so product is zero. And then the change is just the stoichiometry of how this reaction happens. So in this case, Fe is going to lose some amount. We denote that as X. SCN is going to lose the same amount by stoichiometry because it's a one-to-one stoichiometry, so it's also minus X. And then FeSCN2 plus is going to make X amount because it's a one-to-one stoichiometry with the product as well, so it's going to be plus X. So at equilibrium, what you have is you just add the rows of initial and change, so you get this being the equilibrium concentration, Fe3 plus initial minus X for iron, and then this would be for thiocyanate, and of course for FeSCN2 plus, the complex ion, you just have X, okay, which in this case would be FeSCN2 plus. The key here is that in order for us to be able to calculate Kc, right, we already know this quantity because we started with something that we know. We also know this quantity. What we don't know is X. So we need to, in the next video, discuss a method to help us figure out what the concentration of FeSCN is at equilibrium. And that's what I wrote down here, and that's what I will discuss in the next video.